Hello there everybody, and today I wanted to play some zombies, so I decided to play zombies with the Terminator only. If you like this kind of videos, be sure to hit the subscribe button and I will definitely do some more. This is an edited version, so you won't see me playing through the whole game. Also, commentary is afterwards, so just a heads up. But yeah, basically what I did was farm up enough points to immediately open up the first few doors, or actually only the first door, because the only map that I know of you can get the Terminator is the very first one. So I had to open the debris from the stairs, then get 800 bucks to buy the first Terminator. I went downstairs, punched some more fuckers in their faces, and then, buy a secondary Terminator, as you do. But for some people, the Terminator is absolute shit. If you played multiplayer a lot, then you know the Terminator isn't that great. It's a one-shot shotgun. Or like a one round max shotgun, every shot you have to reload. So you might say that's really bad in zombies, but it's actually pretty good as long as you run a tank. What I do, of course, always run tank if you're alone. And make sure to upgrade your health, because it's very handy to have a lot of HP if you play alone and you want to get far. So I got pretty far into the game with the tank. You can get hit about like 10 times if you're a tank, and you can get hit like once as a normal character, and the second time you get knocked down. So unless you play with friends that can heal you, please don't play without tank. It's very handy to have a tank on your team. I farmed like quite a bit of zombies. I punched a lot of them in the faces. That's like the main strategy to do once you got the insta-kill. Just punch them, because it's gonna be a waste of your ammo if you try to shoot all of them. As you know, it's a one-shot normally with the Terminator on the zombies. So if you have insta-kill, it doesn't change anything. You don't save ammo. You could technically shoot in such a way that the bullet spread might hit two or three zombies. That would help. But punching is safer. You can of course just buy new ammo. That's why the Terminator on this map is actually good. You can just buy new ammo as soon as you run out. That's why I don't recommend doing this challenge on any of the other maps. Of course, if you have money, you can technically upgrade it and get ammo back. And I do that quite a bit in this version as well. So that's another option. If you get locked out of the area to get new ammo, you can upgrade it and you get instantly like 10 more ammo, which is really good. But of course, still be aware, it's only 10 ammo. It's not gonna help you that much. If you run two Terminators, you of course have 20 rounds, which means you can take down 20 zombies until you have to get new ammo. And that's like one of the bigger dangers. Now, what actually surprised me a lot is that I knew that it sniped zombies in the start. You could just one-tap them on long ranges. Like, as soon as they spawn in, you can shoot them and they're just gone. Which is very good, I'm not gonna lie. That's very handy about the Terminator. If you run that as secondary on like an AR weapon that you have fully upgraded, you can take out some on far range. And as soon as they enter in the building, just use your AR and spray at them. Especially on this map, I recommend using the STG. Because that one absolutely shreds, especially when you upgrade it. So that's a very good option to use. Outside of that, when you're just playing Terminator only, you can just snipe them before they come in. I snipe every time from like the high point, where you have the two windows to come into. I try to make sure they don't get in there until I get attacked from the back. Which of course is very handy if you are a tank. You don't have to be aware of your back. If you're not playing tank, I advise not to snipe through a window. Stay on a safe spot where you can always check your back. And keep running around. Because as soon as you get hit once, you cannot get hit again. And if they come into your back and you're standing at a window, you most likely get hit at least twice. So yeah, be aware of that if you're not playing a tank. Don't upgrade your Terminator too quick. I did some testing, and until around level 25, you can still one-tap them if they spawn with like a stock Terminator, which is incredible. I advise only upgrade after round 25, your normal Terminators, and if you don't upgrade, or you have trouble getting to your weapon for more ammo, you can upgrade it then. Because if you say, like, I want to upgrade it immediately, and you have that max upgrade, and you run out of ammo, you're fucked, because you're not getting back there. You have to run around for, like, a few minutes before all the zombies are in that spot, and then you can run on and grab more ammo. But then all the zombies are together, which is not a problem. You can just run around them and keep shooting them. But it takes so long to pick all of them off. So you're gonna have to reload again. At the point that you have reloaded once, they're of course all in the reload hallway, which is not that big. You can easily, like, take out quite a bit in there, not gonna lie. But it's not the most efficient place to be. So I advise to try not to hang around there too long. Now, downstairs is actually a pretty nice place to hold. Personally, I like holding upstairs. But that's because I'm used to playing with people, and normally I'm always the doctor. So I'm basically like in the middle then. So I can run everywhere real quick and resurrect people. But when I play tank, I still play the same way, basically. And that's why I like sticking upstairs. I decided not to open the stairs, by the way, to the mystery box. Normally open that pretty quick, because mystery boxes are nice to have. But for this challenge, of course, we don't really need mystery boxes. I ended up getting pretty far, dying almost quite a bit. I even died almost in one of the first rounds. And that's because I was a dumb fuck. And I just stood there waiting for them all to come in, looking at my phone. And when I looked back, I was almost dead. Also, if you see me play and it looks a bit weird, I might have been watching anime the whole time while I was playing this because I was bored. Yeah, that's another tip. If you want to do this and you're not like a person that enjoys single player games without anybody to talk to, like me, be sure to get a friend in with you, because I gotta say it was quite boring from time to time, and that's why I was watching anime during it. Yes, I'm a fucking weeb if you didn't know. But yeah, I ended up getting to round 32, and I gotta say I was feeling pretty good about myself. And then at one point I was like, you know what, I'll open the stairs. That seems like a good idea. Let's go down, open the door, and making the rotation completely possible, I can snipe some more from upstairs. It's gonna be no problem. And I saw the mystery box, and I was like, okay, I got two fully upgraded Terminators. I kind of need to get back to, like, a second tier Terminator anyway. Let's just see what we get out of it. And I decided to open it, and I got a 950 out of it. Basically the BFG from Phantom Forces. It's a one-shot rifle, it's very great, and I decided this is gonna be fun to use for a little while. Turns out it doesn't work in zombies. So it jammed. I picked out my secondary again, or the other Terminator again, to use it a bit to fight him off. Switch back to the sniper rifle, try to shoot him again. Guess what? Still didn't work. I got cornered and I glitched partly into an object, so I couldn't escape anymore. And that was the end of the run. A very depressing end. Not even ended with two Terminators, which is kind of sad. But yeah, that was the end of the run. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and hope to see you guys next time.